Hello everyone, quick intro, I'm Nancy and this video is related to UCD2, which is Ultimate Character Design made by Jazza himself. He made his character design quite a while ago now, I don't even remember which month was it, but yeah, I joined just now, quite late. But still, it took me longer than I expected, I've been actually working on it for 4 days now. But I like it, I'm very proud of it, and I hope you will like it too. For the story, I decided to go with the same prompts as Jazza had for his story. I used the same ones. I just created a completely different story than he did, and obviously different character as well, because I just wanted to see what different story you can do with the same prompts and character as well. It's very different, I would say, than I did, and I really like it, so I hope you like it too. And yeah, that's it for the intro. Enjoy! It was not a happy day when she was born. The birth was too complicated and too difficult for her mother to survive. The mother felt it, and she was scared, but determined to give all her remaining strength to deliver her first and only child alive and healthy. The father held their newborn with shocked and fearful tears in his eyes as he saw tiny black wings piercing through his daughter's back and as he knew his beloved wife was fading away. The mother looked at their daughter, smiled faintly, and with her last breath she said, "My angel." And so the father decided to call their daughter Angela. The father, Matthew, was a very smart and intelligent man, smart enough to know that his daughter would not have an easy life with a pair of wings on her back. He also knew that the ancestors on this continent seemed to have wings themselves, but that was a long time ago, and people were looking for answers about their long-forgotten history for generations, but never found anything. In that age, it was impossible for anyone to be born with wings. And so Matthew started to consider cutting off Angela's wings, so he could give her more chances to have a normal life. But as he held an axe in his trembling hand, looking at his crying baby, he remembered the face of his dying wife smiling at their newborn, not being even slightly startled by those strange wings. She called her an angel. She loved her for what she was, even for those few remaining seconds of her life. Matthew dropped the axe and hugged Angela carefully but firmly, promising to love her forever just as her mother did. Angela was growing up and her wings were growing with her. Matthew was raising her in a small house outside the nearest town where he worked as a historian. He tried to keep her away from people, but he soon realized that Angela was a very curious child, just as he used to be. He knew he wouldn't be able to keep her hidden forever, and so as soon as she could walk and talk, he made her special clothes with a backpack sewn on the back where Angela could hide her wings. Angela loved being with her dad at work, and she wanted to become a historian as well when she grew up. The desire to know more about history grew even stronger when she turned 12. Her wings became too big for the backpack, and it felt painful hiding them. But it was not just her wings that she felt growing. It was also a strange power within her. Since then, things near her started suddenly breaking when she was upset. Sometimes her skin became glowy. And one night while she was sleeping, she had a nightmare, and when she woke up screaming, the closet in front of her set on fire. The more she tried to hold back her power, the bigger accidents happened. Matthew decided to look for the truth once again, and Angela convinced him to take her with him. They tied her wings to her back with a bandage around her chest and waist, and dress her into a long cloak so they could pretend she suffers from a spine illness. They traveled to the biggest historical library on the continent and looked for books they had not read yet. Long days and weeks passed, but they found nothing. Desperate and scared that she would find no answers, Angela suddenly felt her power rising again. She panicked and ran to the corner of the library where her power released itself. It shook the ground, the walls around Angela cracked, and she was showered by 7 pieces and dust. Then she heard several footsteps and her dad calling, but before anyone came, she noticed a hole in the damaged wall next to her. There was an old-looking book inside. Angela didn't hesitate. She grabbed the book and hid it under her cloak. Matthew took Angela away, and together they opened the mysterious book as soon as they were alone. They both realized pretty quickly that this book would finally tell them what they had been looking for. But the truth was rather painful for Angela. A long time ago, there truly were angels on this continent. They were protectors of the world below them. The world that the people on the continent did not know about. There were 3 types of angels. White angels, who were the healers and the source of comfort and compassion for humans below. Black angels, who were the protectors of humans and source of order and justice. And 4 archangels, who were the leaders of all angels. Though angels were blessed with a long life, archangels were actually immortal. None of those angels, however, had the same wings as Angela did. Even the black angel's wings, though dark, were feathered and glorious. Angela had never seen even the smallest feather on her leathery wings. Angels were originally worshipped by humans, but as long years passed, more and more humans started to look for their own freedom, as they had to follow the rules that archangels created. First, they started revolting against the black angels, but their power and strength was very hard to defeat. And so humans started attacking white angels, who were completely defenseless because they were born with pure love inside them and they did not know anger. This act enraged the black angels, and they started to fight back harder than ever, which evolved into a battle. In that moment, archangels flew down to the human world for the first time, stopped the battle, and summoned all angels back to their continent. What happened next left all the angels in shock and surprise. Archangels commanded them to stay on the continent, as they sensed that the age of angels and humans on this world was coming to its end. The angels were confused. It was their purpose to protect and guide humans. They tried to convince the archangels to let them fly down and put things back in order, but archangels forbade it and said that humans could not be helped anymore. Amongst the archangels, there was one called the Seer. He could see the future, but not at his will. The visions were coming to him when it was needed, and he saw that humans would completely lose their trust and belief in angels. However, that was not all that came to him. One vision started to take its shape behind his closed eyes, and it took long weeks or months to form completely. When he opened his eyes, other archangels noticed fear in them. The Seer told them about an angel with black leathery wings who would be born amongst the black angels in long years to come. This angel will possess terrifyingly strong power with which he will kill all archangels and convince the black angels to join him. Later, he will rule the humans below them and make them worship the angels again out of fear. And so, archangels decided to sacrifice all black angels for the greater good. They destroyed their wings and took all their powers from them. White angels were left untouched. However, humans' rage and disbelief in them and the loss of the black angels made them so weak that not even archangels could help them, and they died. The seer's vision changed. The humans were safe, and that age truly came to its end. And so the archangels spread their wings and flew away from this continent to the unknown. Matthew and Angela were left speechless after they discovered the truth, not just about the ancestors and their history, or about the world below them, but about Angela herself. Realizing she was the reason why there were no angels on this continent anymore, and scared that there was a monster hiding inside her as the seer saw her in his vision, she started trembling uncontrollably. Her skin became glowy and her eyes filled with tears. Matthew reached to hug her, but she dodged and stepped back quickly, as she was scared she could hurt him with her power. Matthew, however, was not scared of her power, and he reached again and embraced her carefully but firmly. Angela cried and begged him to cut off her wings, because she didn't want to become the monster that they described. But Matthew replied, "You are not a monster. You are my angel, and I love you." And with those words, Angela slowly calmed down. They traveled back home, and since then, they started examining Angela's power, as Matthew believed that it needed to be controlled rather than hidden and unpredictable. And as Angela was slowly growing up into a young woman, she became one with her power. And yet, she kept her true self hidden from the rest of the world, as she feared what outcome it might bring.